In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this really cool modern cabin in Revit. I was looking at these images online, I thought it looked really cool, and why not take this opportunity to create another Revit gameplay tutorial? Let's go! Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be because we have over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics in Revit. Also, there you can find some really high quality Revit templates, families, and plugins. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we have just an image. Now, this is going to kind of serve as an elevation image, even though it's really a perspective image. However, it's the best we have, so this is what we're going to be working with. We already have levels here set at the bottom and where the kind of the top level is. And also we have this reference plane just kind of indicating the access of this roof. Okay, so now to get us started, as I said, we're in elevation view, so this is south elevation. Let's first create the roof, and for this roof, we're going to be modeling it as an extrusion. So open up the drop menu, find roof by extrusion, and here we need to set the work plane, and I already have a plane, so I'm just going to pick it by name, and it's going to be this reference plane roof. And then let's click OK. Now this is going to be on either level 1 or 2, doesn't really matter. Let's just click OK. And now let us get started. So for this roof, I first want to set the roof type. So I'm just going to set this to this particular one, which was created for this tutorial. And then let's use lines, and I'm just going to follow kind of the straight pieces of this roof. So I'm just going to create one straight line like that, hit the escape key once, create one line like this, going all the way down, hit the escape key once again, and now following the bottom line here of this, just like that, hit the escape key a couple of times. Okay, so now to connect this, we want to just use fillet arc tool to basically fillet this. So let's find here the fillet arc, and then I'm just going to connect these two, and then you can just extend that to the top, something like that. And as you can see, it's going to extend those lines, which is perfect. Now let's repeat that here. So just like this, extend it up to there. Perfect. Hit the escape key a couple of times. And now I want to delete this line because this isn't going to be a roof. It's going to be modeled later on as a floor. So let's delete that and then let's hit finish. And here we go. Now, if I open up the 3D view, this is what that looks like. Now here we have this issue of, well, this very sharp edge. I just want this to be cut kind of parallel to the ground or to the water. So let's select the roof and then go to the properties panel. And here for construction, for rafter cut, let's change it from plumb cut to square and hit apply. And now, as you can see, it's going to be flat on that side. Okay, now moving forward, let's open up the level 1 or 2 floor plan, select the roof, and then let's extend it here. So I have these reference planes kind of just marking out the how long this roof should be. So now it looks like that. Okay, now moving forward, let's talk about kind of the front edge of this thing. So what I want to do is I want to kind of mimic the image here where this one side is a little bit swooped away. It's also going to make it possible for people to walk around this roof into the kind of front of the house. So to create that, what we have is here, if I open up the west elevation, for example, or east elevation, you will see that here we have this reference plane, and it's basically marking here the top of the roof. So I want to have a void cutting this opening just like that. Now this was already named roof void RV. So then let's go back to our south elevation, and then let's go here to component, open up the drop menu and go to model in place. And then here I'm just going to search for roofs just like this, click OK. Roofs one, that's perfectly fine. Click OK. And now let's create a void extrusion. Now for the plane, I'm just going to go with RV, click OK. And here what I'll do is I'm just going to go from the center and then towards the right, just like this, and then hit finish. And now let's go to the 3D view. It looks like this. So now I just want to extend it here. So that looks all right. However, it's cutting really from the top. However, I want to cut from the bottom here. So let's give it an extrusion start off. Let's try 4. Okay, that's not nearly enough. Let's do 40 for 4 centimeters. 50. We're getting close. Let's go with 80. Okay, I think this will work. Perhaps 70. Is going to give us kind of the right dimension. Okay, I think this looks correct. Perfect. And now we just need to make the cut. So for that, you go here to cut geometry, select the roof or what you're cutting, select what you're cutting with, which is the void. And there we go. So now it has a nice clean cut here. Hit finish. There we go. So this isn't even noticeable. And we have that nice swoop. So now you can walk here in front and enter the house. I really like this shape. Another thing that we want to fix here is the fact that we have this wood on the face. We don't want that. We want wood on the inside, however, not on the face of this roof. So let's go, while we're here on the modify panel, let's go to paint, and then we should have some clad white. There we go, that one. And then I'm just going to select that and apply it here, here, and then in the back as well on that face. There we go. So now it looks much, much better. Click done. Okay, moving forward, let's now do the floors. So let's go down to level 1. So here for level 1, let's go to architecture, floor, rectangle, and then let's pick out this one, which was created for this tutorial. And then we can extend it just like that. Hit finish, go to the 3D view. Perfect. Yeah, looks really, really nice. Now we can drop this down or move the roof up. I prefer to move the roof up. Also make sure you select the void as well. So make a selection like that. Go to the south elevation, zoom in, move, and then we should probably move from, it's really difficult here to see where that is. It's kind of hard to pinpoint. Let's try that again. Let's use thin lines. Pick that again, move this up. There we go. Oops. Yeah, that seems to look correct. It didn't mess up the void. Let's see. Yeah. And now everything is in line. Perfect. Now for the second level floor, I'm just going to zoom in here. Again, go to floor. I'm just going to use the same one and go with a rectangle. And then let's go like this. So I'm just going to go a little bit on the inside, in the back, and then a bit more to the inside and the front, just because we want to have that kind of open area. And then hit finish. Okay, that looks nice. Perfect. And then we can just go to modify, join geometry, and then we can join the roof with the floor. Yeah, perfect. Okay, moving forward, let's now create the glass part of this building. So for that, let's move into level 1. And then let's go to architecture, go to wall, and then pick out a curtain wall. So what we also want to do perhaps is hit the escape key a couple of times and set the underlay to level 2. So I can see where that floor above is. Okay, so let's go now to wall, curtain wall, perfect. And then let's go from here, hit the space key to flip it to the other side. Go to the other side like that. Then you want to go to the back. And then here you want to go again to the same place. Yeah, kind of like that. Perfect. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this one. So I'll first shape the one in the front, and then we'll just copy it back. I think that's better. Okay, so once we have this in place, let's see, it looks correct. Perhaps this one can move a bit in. So I'm just using the arrow keys here. Let's set this to the front. Yeah, perhaps just like this. Perfect. Okay, so now let's select this wall in the front, go into edit profile, use pick lines, and then pick the inner lines of this roof, just like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times. So here we need just a small kind of line, hit the escape key a few times, go to trim and extend to corner, and then fix it up here. and fix it up here. And then the rest of the lines, we can just select and delete. Okay, so once we have this, we can hit finish. Looks perfect. This one, we're just going to bring down to there. Perfect again. And now let's select this thing, go into level one. And then here, what they'll do is I'm just going to mirror it. Let's go with draw axis, find the center line of this floor. And now it's going to bring it here to the back. There we go. So we have it in the front and in the back as well. And let's now add some mullions and curtain grids, just as a kind of finishing touch. So for that, let's go here to curtain grid. Let's do all segments, and we can place one perhaps like that. Then let's do one segment in the center here. Yeah, I think this looks fine. Then off to the side at, I don't know, like 750 or something. Same thing on the other side. And then let's adjust these. So something like that, I think, will work. Okay, now let's apply some mullions. So let's go to mullions, all grids, and let's do that here, here, do one in the back, just to add, just make it a bit more realistic. There we go, hit the escape key a few times. And there we go. Now we have this really, really cool modern cabin. Of course, you can take this further, model the actual lake, add some furniture, so on and so forth. But overall, this is the approach I would use to create this shape for this cool cabin. So I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you want to get access to this Revit project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.